Hello, grade 3. Today we will be reading the story First Around the Globe, The Story of Enrique, written by Rene Rojas and Mark Singer. Let's go ahead and read this book. What would you say if we told you that the first man to circle the earth was not a Spaniard or a Portuguese, but a Filipino named Enrique? Enrique was born on the island of Cebu. Like his fellow islanders, he might have lived and died without ever seeing much of the world that lay beyond the horizon. One day, while he was fishing, Enrique was kidnapped by a band of pirates. They took him to Jolo, where he was sold to the slave trade in Malacca. It was there that the young Cebuano first met Ferdinand Magellan. Magellan was a Portuguese explorer who lived in a time of adventure and discovery. He was working in Malacca, a Portuguese colony in the Malay Peninsula. Malacca was a trading port where goods and services were sold, including slaves. One day, at the slave auction, Magellan heard one of the slaves speaking a language he had never heard of. The young man told him that he came from a land that lay to the east beyond Sabah. The explorer grew excited. He had only traveled as far as Sabah, and now he dreamed of claiming this undiscovered place for Portugal. Magellan paid for the slave, and the young man became his servant. He was baptized and given the Christian name Enrique. In 1512, Magellan returned to Portugal. Enrique went with him. Magellan asked the Portuguese king to grant him the ships that he needed to reach a place east of Sabah and north of the Moluccas. He would claim the region in the name of the Portuguese Empire, but the Portuguese king ignored him. Magellan did not give up hope. Instead, he asked the king of Spain for help. He told the king that these islands would give Spain as much riches as gold of Peru and the silver of Mexico. Magellan presented Enrique and a woman from Sumatra to the Spanish royal court. The couple were dressed in colorful native clothes. The Spanish king agreed to pay for the expedition. A year and a half later, Magellan and five ships, called caravels, left the south of Spain for their long sea journey. Enrique went along as interpreter. Before leaving Seville, Magellan made out his will, in which he wrote, "I declare and ordain that from the day of my death, thenceforward, forever, my captured slave Enrique, of the age of 26 years, more or less, shall be free." Magellan never told Enrique that he would be a free man at the time of the explorer's death. As soon as the sea voyage began, there was trouble. Some of the Spanish officers mutinied against the Portuguese navigator. Two of the five ships turned back. Magellan continued his journey with only three caravels. The three ships passed through the Straits of South America and joined the vast Pacific Ocean. For 18 months, those aboard suffered great thirst and hunger. The crew ran out of food. They were forced to eat biscuits swarming with worms and sawdust from wooden boards. Magellan's men wondered if they would ever live to see this land Magellan set out to discover. On March 16, 1521, Magellan reached the island of Samar. The next day, the vessels dropped anchor further south, off an island named Monhon. The crews rested there for a week, tending to the sick among them. Magellan expected Enrique to translate his words to the islanders, but the Cebuano could not understand the people of Samar, who spoke a different language called Waray-Waray. Magellan's ship then sailed southward, docking at the island of Limasawa, Leyte. A small native boat bearing eight men cautiously approached the ships. When Enrique spoke to them, he was at once understood. The next day, Magellan sent Enrique ashore to ask their chieftain for food and to say that they had come as friends, not enemies. The king of Limasawa, Raja Colombo, gave Magellan three jars full of rice and two large fish. In return, Magellan gave the Raja clothes made out of fine cloth. He gave small knives and mirrors to the Raja's guards. Later, the Raja invited the Europeans to eat with him in his banana palm leaf place. Magellan found out that the richest and busiest port in the region was a place called Cebu. He set sail again and entered the port of Cebu on April 7, 1521. He and his men stayed there 3 weeks as the guest of the Cebu's chieftain, Raja Humabon. Raja Humabon told Magellan that a proud chieftain from the nearby island of Mactan refused to honor him as his leader. His name was Lapu-Lapu. To please the Cebuano chief, Magellan sent Enrique to Mactan with a message for Lapu-Lapu. Should you refuse to accept Raja Humabon as your leader, you will be taught how sharp Spanish lances are. Enrique returned with Lapu-Lapu's answer. We have lances of our own with points hardened by fire. So, did you like the story? What do you think happened next? Let's continue this story next library class. For today's activity, share your thoughts on what will happen next in the story. Write your answer in a clean sheet of paper. And once you're done, please post it in Seesaw. Enjoy!